Over the years, I've watched many sad anime, and the good ones made me cry. And honestly, it felt good to cry. I didn't only cry because the premise of whatever anime I was watching was sad, but also cried because in some way I could relate to the anime characters, which can't be said for most anime. The anime I'll be talking about today is among the ones that made me bawl almost every episode. In fact, it would probably be the anime that made me cry the most. It's not necessarily a new anime, but it most certainly is an underrated one. And since I want you guys to watch this anime as well, this will be a spoiler-free video, so rest assured and watch the whole thing. The anime I'm talking about is Anohana. To those who watched the series, you'd probably agree with me in that this anime is a very good tearjerker anime. The series follows Jinta Yadami, a teenager who completely isolated himself from the real world. He doesn't go to school, doesn't have a social life, he is the definition of an introvert. But this wasn't always his reality. Ever since his mother and one of his best friends, Menma, died, he came to realize his life is meaningless. One summer, Jinta sees a ghost version of Menma appear and pester him about a wish he forgot to grant for Jinta. After realizing he's not hallucinating, Jinta tries to figure out what the forgotten wish is. Slowly, Jinta's childhood friends who lost touch with Jinta decided to help Menma remember the wish and help her grant it in order to help Menma finally rest in peace. All of Jinta's friends are suffering because of Menma's death, and we get to see how all of them are dealing with their loss and how we as viewers can get past hard times as well. Anohana dives into many relationship problems and how to deal with them. We not only see Jinta and his friends figure out the situation with Menma, but we also see Jinta's father and how he's dealing with Jinta being his mother as well as father figure in his life. Created by A1 Pictures, who have also made the many critically acclaimed anime such as Kimi no Uso, Erased, and The Promised Neverland, among many other sad yet compelling anime. Anohana doesn't cheap out on the animation, and I'd say it was above average animation on their part. For those of you who like to watch romance as well, then not fear, because Anohana covers that aspect too. There's a pretty complicated love triangle, or should I say love pentagon, because there's 5 of them, but nonetheless, the romance Anohana deals with is also very realistic, and I'm sure it will relate to most of you in some way. On top of that, I can't recommend the soundtrack enough. It's a perfect blend of sad and pop music that it doesn't completely give away that it's meant to be sad, but it lets the viewers interpret the situation, and it still does its job in a way. Not to mention that the whole soundtrack is very humble. What I mean by that is that it's not something that overbears the whole anime, and it's just to the point where it pushes you over the edge and makes you drop a tear. Anohana is the only anime I've watched that made me cry, of sadness as well as joy, and it is one of the most relatable anime I've watched to date. So why not watch it for yourself? If you like it, then why not subscribe to me as a way of saying thank you. But anyway, bye guys.